Here we will practice answering the second loopy question with array diagrams. Remember that the second loopy question, does it stop right, helps us develop our loop condition, B. Consider the invariant and post condition shown here. What condition, along with the invariant, tells us that the post condition is true? We can see that when the unknown region is empty, the invariant will look like the post condition. When is the segment empty? Let's use the follower minus the first rule. For this segment, J is the follower and H is the first. If we want the number of elements in the segment to be 0, then the follower minus the first should equal 0. J minus H should equal 0, or H equals J, which is not B. So when this is the case, the loop should stop. This makes B, H is not equal to J. Alternatively, we can say the loop should stop when H is at least J. This means B could also be H is less than J. That yields the following loop conditions. In general, the loop should terminate when some segment of the array diagram is empty. All we have to do is write down the condition for that segment being empty. In general, a segment will be empty when the first equals the follower or the first is at least the follower. Some people will write the loop condition like this. We will not do this because H comes before J visually in the invariant. Here is a second example. Pay attention to where J is in the diagram. Here J is on the left of the second vertical line, rather than on the right. Here, we can see that the unknown segment B sub H dot dot J has a value in it as long as H is at most J. Note that if H is equal to J, the segment still contains one element. So we write the loop condition B as H is at most J. This leads to the loop shown. Note that we could also use the follower minus the first rule here. But be careful, J is not the follower as in the previous example. The follower would be J plus 1. In this case, looking for a pattern in the picture was a simpler way to reason about the loop condition. The following exercises are for you. Develop the loop condition B given the invariant and post condition. The answers are at the end of the document that accompanies this video.